The Old Premeds Podcast, session number 193. You're a non-traditional student entering the medical field on your terms. You may have had some hiccups along the way, but now you're ready to change course and go back and serve others as a physician. This podcast is here to help answer your questions and help educate you on your non-traditional journey to becoming a physician. And welcome to the Old Premeds Podcast. My name is Dr. Ryan Gray. And in this podcast, I take your questions from our forums over at premedforums.com and answer them here on the podcast. Mostly, we focus on non-traditional questions. This week, a little bit more of a regular question for any traditional or non-traditional student, but this is still a great question to answer. Our question today is from Maria, and she asks, "Hi, I'm curious to know if anyone has any experience or tips for someone who's thinking of applying to a brand new medical school. My undergraduate, University of Houston, is opening its new medical school at exactly the time when I'll be ready to apply. So if I went there, I'd be in the first cohort. Does anyone have any helpful advice on this? I know a few new schools have popped up in the last few years, and would love to hear what it was like to be in one of the early classes. I imagine the school wouldn't be completely organized, and that might add some extra stress, but it also seems like a neat experience. Thanks for any feedback." So here are my thoughts. Now, I didn't go to a brand new medical school. When I went to medical school, I didn't apply to any that I can think of. When I was applying to medical school and went to medical school, the trend that we're seeing now with a lot of new medical schools opening up wasn't happening. It was very stale and not a new school environment. And so what you're seeing now is a lot of schools are opening up. There's a lot of demand. There's a lot of research that says we're going to have a big physician shortage. And so schools are going, hey, we can make some money on tuition. Let's open up a medical school. And so students are put in the situation of applying to new schools, old schools, brown schools, blue schools, right? We'll make this a Dr. Seuss rhyme as well. But what you will find is that if you look at the history of schools, at least recent history, I can't find any. I haven't heard of any. Maybe you have different data. You've seen something that I haven't seen, but I haven't seen any school that's gotten their preliminary accreditation and has graduated their first class and didn't get their full accreditation. So the process that schools have to go through is they have to get a preliminary accreditation from either the AOA, which accredits, and there's something else in there too, but for DO schools, or the LCME for MD schools. And those two accreditation bodies will tell the schools, look, you are preliminary accredited. You can open up and accept applications for your first class. But it's not until those schools graduate that first class in 4 years' time, or 3 years for some schools now, graduate their first class that they can get a full accreditation. Schools that are doing this, that are opening up, they don't typically, right? Again, that I've seen, they don't have any issues getting that full accreditation. Like, as Maria pointed out, are there potential obstacles, roadblocks, stumbling blocks, kind of hurdles that have to be overcome? Sure. But those things happen even at fully accredited, long-standing schools as well, where you have dynamics between professors and administrators and everything else, where you have maybe a new dean come in and they don't really see eye to eye with an old curriculum director, whatever may happen. Those kinds of things happen everywhere. Now, maybe it's a little bit more stable because it's like, hey, this is the way we've always done it, so we can do it. At new schools, there is no, this is the way we've always done it. But you also have to remember that a lot of these schools are pulling in administrators from other schools. And so for the most part, the people kind of seeding these new schools as far as administrators and faculty and everything else, a lot of them are coming from other places where things have been done one way or another. And so they can bring their experiences and their knowledge to the new school. And so, yes, there will be obstacles and challenges, but that's everywhere and not necessarily just a new school thing. So in the grand scheme of things, is there a quote risk in applying to new schools? No, there isn't. In the grand scheme of things, will going to and applying at a new school or for a new school, will going to that new school hinder you in any way? Again, in the grand scheme of things, in your life as a physician, no, it won't. Again, small obstacles here, there, sure. Again, that's every place. In the grand scheme of things, apply to schools you want to go to, apply to schools that are going to be a good fit for you. If it's a school like one of the new schools that I talked to their dean, Dr. King Lee, a couple years ago on the Pre-Med Years podcast, that's Carl, Illinois College of Medicine, an amazing new engineering-based medical school. And that's a brand new school. They're flipping the model kind of 180 degrees on what they're doing. And a lot of students resonated with that. And they said, yes, you're a new school, but you are what I've been looking for. And so that a school like that is an amazing opportunity. And you want new schools like that opening that are trying to push the boundaries and really change the way things are done, because change is good and pushing those boundaries is good. So if you haven't checked out those interviews that I've done with Carl, Illinois College of Medicine, go check out the Pre-Med Years. My newest episode I did with them was with their recruitment director. You can check that out at medicalschoolhq.net/349, talking all about their secondary applications and the fact that they don't do interviews and much more. Great conversation. So new schools, not a problem, nothing to worry about. And yes, it is an adventure. I hope that was helpful for you. If you have a question you want answered here on the Old Premeds podcast, go to premedforms.com. Register for an account if you don't already have one and ask your question. Hope you have a great week. We'll see you next time here on the Old Premeds podcast.
This is MedEd Media.